Andre Overdahl hangs with the Boo crew, Barbara and Andy Muschietti are producing a new Stephen King adaptation, and Danny Trejo is a real-life hero. You're watching This Week in Horror. If you didn't already know, Bloody Disgusting has an awesome podcast network. And this week on a surprise episode of The Boo Crew, director Andre Overdahl stopped by for a spoiler-free chat about his adaptation of Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark, which is in theaters now. The podcast is a great listen for before or after the film and includes discussions on so many things. How they choose what elements to take from the infamous books to translate into the film, the process of bringing Stephen Gamel's terrifying and iconic artwork to life, Andre's creative partnership with Guillermo del Toro, where they found that amazing haunted house, and so much more. The Boo Crew and Andre also chatted about his earlier works, Troll Hunter, and The Autopsy of Jane Doe. Check out this episode of The Boo Crew on BloodyDisgusting.com, Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever else you got your podcasts. Back in the late 70s and early 80s, Stephen King began writing under the pseudonym Richard Bachman. And in 1981, Bachman wrote a novel called Roadwork, and now Barbara and Andy Muschietti are producing a film adaptation of that novel to be directed by Pablo Trapero. The book's description reads, "It's all coming to an end for Barton Dawes. The city's Highway 784 extension is in the process of being constructed right across town and inexorably through every aspect of Bart's existence. Whether it's about to barrel over the laundry plant where he makes a living, or soon to smash through the very home where he makes a life. But as a result, something's been happening inside Bart's head that a heartless local bureaucracy isn't prepared for, a complete and irrevocable burnout of the mental circuit breaker that keeps a mild-mannered person from turning to violent means. As the wheels of progress and a demolition crew continue unabated throughout Bart's neighborhood, he's not about to give everything up without a fight. As a matter of fact, he's ready and waiting to ignite an explosive confrontation with the legislative forces gathered against him." Barbara Muschietti told Radio Cantilo that, quote, "It's a fantastic script. We hope to start shooting at the beginning of next year. We'll give you more updates as we hear them." And finally, everyone's favorite machete-wielding badass Danny Trejo became a real-life hero this week. After saving a young child trapped in an overturned car in Sylmar, California. ABC7 said that Trejo just happened to be nearby when the two cars collided after one of the cars ran a red light. One of the vehicles was on its roof, and a young child was trapped inside their car seat. Trejo and another bystander helped rescue the child. The boy's grandmother was trapped in the driver's seat, but firefighters were able to free her while Trejo looked after and distracted the boy. Trejo said, quote, "He was panicked. I said, okay, we have to use our superpowers. So we screamed, superpowers, and we started yelling, superpowers. We got kind of a bond. I kept facing him away from the accident." We've always heard such great things about Danny Trejo, so is it really that big of a surprise that he's as badass in life as he is in the movies? I don't think so. That's all the news this week. For more horror news, be sure to head on over to BloodyDisgusting.com. See you next time.